Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you again for joining me again tonight. So this will be my third upload this week, but hey, why not? I hope you're having a good weekend. I hope you're feeling good about yourself, and most of all, you look fantastic. So this is a completely different kind of vlog that I'm doing, something I'm not used to, but something that I've not really delved into or I've not done before. And the reason why I'm doing it is because I find it interesting, not in a crazy psychotic way, but just interesting because it looks into the psychological workings of a person, if that makes any sense. Probably doesn't, but anyway. So as you will gather by the title, we are doing cults. So, I'm not sure if this cult is recognised a lot. I'm probably not the first person to talk about it, but I haven't done the research, so if anyone says I'm copying them, I'm actually not. This is just an idea that came to me today, literally out of thin air. And I know that there's been a lot of research and talk about, like, the Charles Manson cult. That's very popular for the reasons being that it's well known. There is lots of cults in the world, small ones, big ones, but yeah. So I was gonna look into a serial killer, but first of all, I stopped myself because I don't want that serial killer getting fame or recognised for the heinous crimes that they're doing. It's not fair on the victims, and I don't know, I just don't think that I just stopped doing it for some reason. It didn't feel like the right time. So here we are. We are going to be looking at, I hope I say this right, the Butterfield cult, which was led by Jamie Gomez. I probably said that wrong. Some people say Jamie Gomez, some say Jaime Gomez or Jaime Gomez. I'm not sure, so don't hate me for saying it wrong if I did. That's just how I read it as an English person. Hate me, whatever, don't come for me, I don't know. You might be thinking, did you not mean Buddha? Or what's Buddha got to do with it? Or do you not mean Butterfield? Or Butterfield? No. I'll write it at the bottom for you so you can see. It is Butterfield, the cult. Now, when I looked into this cult, into the leader, who, for purposes of my benefit, I'm going to call him Jamie Gomez, because that's how I... Or can I say Jaime? 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 I can't. I'm just going to stick with... I'll try and meet in the middle. I'll call him Jaime Gomez. Shall I? I mean, as an English person, it's Jamie. Screw it. I'm gonna call him Jamie Gomez. Come for me in the comments if you want, but that's how I read his name. I know it's not the correct spelling, the correct way of saying it, but just bear with me. So, yeah, this is how unfamiliar that he is to me, because of all the cults I've heard about, he's definitely not a name that has come up a lot, therefore hence why I don't really know the correct pronunciation or correct way to say it. Bear with me. So yes, what I was going to say is Jamie, there's not a lot of information that I can find on his background or his parents, other than he was born by a very rich and wealthy Venezuelan farmer. Before I go into his history, some brief points that I'm going to shoot at you for now. He's from the USA, born in Los Angeles, I do believe. In 1950, he went to Hollywood to try and be an actor, and I believe he was in some movies, such like Rosemary's Child or something. He wanted to start the New Religious Movement, He's also known as, again, I don't know if I'm saying this right, Michael or Mitchell Roston. I don't know if I'm saying these names right. You will be able to find more video evidence of the cult's activity or inside stuff from a former cult member called Will Allen, who produced the movie Holy Hell, which you can find online anywhere. But yeah, that gives a bit more insight because he was kind of documenting, he was kind of the group's or the cult's videographer, documentary kind of person for a while. So a lot of information that you see online is usually from what he was able to record. And one funny thing, if you want to say funny thing about Jamie Gomez, he was quite proud of himself, proud of his person, his body, quite full of pride. Some might say have a big ego, but it was very, very well known that if you were to see him, he would be, I can't believe I'm saying this, he would be constantly seen, more than anything, in Speedos. Yes. And wearing eyeliner. So he was quite a character when you first meet him. It's a bit like, okay. And through a lot of his cult leadership, he is well known to, more than occasionally, walk around naked. Because as he once put, or once was noted to say, something along the lines of, if you're not comfortable walking around naked in front of other people, how can you be comfortable in front of God?
So your master, you can't stand naked in front of your God.
Like that. He also has, I believe, some form of Netflix series going on how to be a cult leader, which again, you can find that on Netflix apparently. If I can find it, I'll link it down below. So his new age religious ideas, or the basis around his cult, was the belief that people should see themselves as God, or should see God in themselves. Jamie was also known to consider himself as God. He also made use of the practice of Shakti. Again, I don't know if I'm saying this right at all. I think it was a Sanskrit practice or something known in English meaning power. This was a common practice. He would basically use hypnotherapy, or he was that manipulative. He would somehow control his followers through the use of his finger. Take that how you want it. But it was all the power in this thing, and he would be using it to, I don't know if he was pointing at you or getting you to look at his eyes like this or doing this and what, I don't know. But yeah, he was well known to use the power of the pinky, of the finger, sorry, not the pinky. Gomez's practices are known to recite the, I'm going to say this wrong, Bhagavad Gita, something like that, which was basically the idea that there's a battlefield that you're experiencing in yourself. It's like an interpretation, if I'm saying this right, you're struggling to find yourself in human life, if that makes any sense. So you're trying to think of yourself as God, but trying to find your humanly place. Yeah. And as mentioned before, briefly, he came to Hollywood to be an actor. He did get some roles, but not enough. Fair to say his acting career did come to an end very, very quickly. However, one of his followers actually was quite proud to say that when she did know him, he was, and I quote, just a lovely guy, smart, funny, good looking, charismatic, and speaking in her, I loved him. So Jamie eventually gathered quite a few names, or a few AKAs, also known as, some nicknames at one point, well, used in many points during his cult leadership. He was known as the teacher. He was known as Andreas. His followers often called him Ray G. which means God King. So a few of his followers include a few of them that have been able to be interviewed or recognised. These are ex-followers of the cult. They were Chris Johnston, Julia Goldstein, Alessandra Bernheim, or Bjornheim, Radhi Gleiss. A few of these you can actually find online. I believe Radia now has her own YouTube channel as well, or a podcast, which she does read segments of her book The Following, which is kind of basically based on the Holy Hell documentary based on the cult. Now, they will all say and claim, and again there's been no reason not to believe them, that they will all claim that they were brainwashed by Jamie Gomez, which again is a cult leader, so quite often they do a lot of manipulation, which is brainwashing. Of course, when asked about this or questioned, Jamie did deny any of this. Now, some of the many ways that Jamie managed to get his followers were commonly known as mind games, tricks, or manipulation, parlor tricks. He was somehow able to be very good at this and control his followers. He even used these mind games to evade taxes. Now, sadly, as with any cult, there were some allegations that were highlighted, as you might say, regarding his practice as a cult leader. Such things as you were not allowed to buy a TV outside of the cult. As with every other cult, you have your own community, your own circle, you stay in that circle. The cult leader will provide you with whatever radio, TV you're allowed, the books, education, whichever. They will make sure that they give you the stuff that you are supposed to read, look at, listen to, because that is part of the manipulation. There was a lot of bullying, as in if Jamie suspected that one of his followers were not 100% committed, they would be questioned, or he would ask one of his other followers to be kind of a spy and get close to that follower just to make sure that they were committed, there was nothing they were hiding, nothing they were conspiring against him. Surprisingly, he did not allow, well, he made a strict diet, which was no gluten, no sugar, no drugs or alcohol. So despite a lot of followers saying that they had an amazing time in this cult, they were forbidden these luxuries, as you might say, to some people. Other cult routines included, I don't know why, well, maybe because he was an actor and stuff like that, but included three sessions, three times a week of ballet dancing. That was an activity for them, apparently. Now, some cult members may still have had work and jobs outside of the cult, but due to Jamie's encouragement to commit fully to the cult, they either missed a lot of work or just lost their jobs completely and ended up staying in the cult forever, basically, because they just weren't allowed to be outside. There was still an influence there. People could maybe sense a change in that person's personality, the way they were acting, speaking, whichever. So he just couldn't risk it, and they just didn't have any work. One of the ways in which a follower described entering the cult was, it's basically like walking into a new world where you would take off your shoes, drop your ego, and become a new person. It was like a transfer of energy, apparently, into the new world. So you were leaving your old life behind, or your old world, and making a new one. You were basically empowering yourself in a new world. Now, I will invert some videos for you here so that you can see a brief situation of what it was like in the cult. Be warned, it's a bit out there.
It was the middle of the 80s and we wanted something different.
They were so alive. living from their heart and playing and jumping in ice-cold rivers and hiking through the forest at night. And oh my God, I want me some of that.
We started it. This is what we wanted. It was our little utopia.
And we were all there because of this one man.
He's very charismatic, like a child, very playful. He could dance, he was artistic. He was all those things we all wanted to be.
He was just this beautiful, silent entity.
And I said, I would follow you anywhere.
Elevated him to the role of an awakened master. He spoke as if he had gone into the cosmos and come back.
He said, what are you willing to give up to know God?
It's not like we were forced to be there. We wanted to be there.
He always told us we're an anti-cult.
I was hallucinating, colors were moving around him, and I thought, I found it.
I really felt like I had a purpose in my life.
He just became stranger and stranger and more paranoid and more possessive.
You can't say no. No is against the rules.
He wanted to be worshipped. He wanted to be God.
If you can stand naked in front of your master, you can stand naked in front of your God.
What's the scientific, rational explanation for this madness?
It was so hard to believe, but I trusted him. I never dreamed it would happen like this. I thought we would be together our entire lives.
Now, trigger warning, some allegations that came from those that left the cult eventually not particularly nice. It went in line with some of the rules that he had. For instance, you had to be celibate. Everybody in the cult had to be celibate. You could not give yourself to a partner or give your body to anybody else. However, like every other cult leader, Jamie did not mind indulging in these activities with other people. The celibacy ended near him and with him. Furthermore, again, trigger warning, if by any chance one of the women became pregnant from these activities, he somehow manipulated them to have abortions because in his way, in his mind, in his teaching, it went against everything they religiously stood for. Take that as you will. Yeah, so he can do all these things as usual, but with God. In another way, he would say that having children and gaining personal enlightenment, which is what they were meant to do by embracing a God in themselves, did not mix. Again, I don't know how anybody would agree with this, but he was very manipulative, so obviously a lot of people just listened to him without thinking or having a second thought. Ironically, going back to what I was saying about the activities, even though they were doing a lot of ballet, people used to comment how there was never a performance, there was never a finale. It was just constant ballet dancing. But again, if you're being manipulated and brainwashed, I'm guessing he was just using these activities to keep them occupied. Well, there are allegations of, you could say, psychological abuse, possibly. Abuse of power, even. Jamie became quite encouraged with plastic surgery, and again, not including males, he would encourage the women to get plastic surgery to make them look more better or more desirable, to embrace their empowerment. Again, even though Jamie was indulging in his sexual life, he did make a massive point about the AIDS crisis when it came about, and this scared a lot of the male followers who might be gay by saying that if you catch it with anybody outside, you can endanger all of us. So obviously no one knew how to deal with AIDS back then, so that would have put a lot of fear in a lot of male followers. And knowing that it has been known or noted that Jamie did not just end with sleeping with his female followers, he was also sleeping with the male ones. I'm guessing that was his way of making sure no one got sick, especially himself. On a few few occasions, or one occasion actually maybe, he did try to leave his cult, or he did, on one occasion he did leave his cult to go find a new location. In this situation he would leave some spies in his cult whilst he was gone, just to make sure that nobody was conspiring against him. Again, another form of manipulation and control. At one point, one follower actually said, I think she was known as Decipher, something like that. She wanted to go see her father who was on his deathbed, but basically Jamie was having none of it and she did not get to see him, and sadly he did pass away. Sadly, other forms of abuse were, again, abuse with females and males once they realised about manipulation, and it was basically non-consensual, obviously. He used confessions as a reason to bully and blackmail members, because they would have weekly confessions with him, obviously being inside the cult, and he would use that as a leverage against them to make sure they didn't leave, that they would spread his confessions. So yeah, there was a lot of harassment, a lot of bullying, abuse in more ways than one. And the whole time he would just pretend that he was fine and in charge of everything. A few people did leave, a few people did stay. It just depended on their loyalty to him and how far they were hypnotized to believe him. It was said that, I think by Chris Johnston, which I'll put the text up here, when he finally decided he did not want to take any more abuse, he basically denied wanting it. And basically Gomez was like, you don't want to behave, basically, which I'll put up here.
Cannot be put it in a biographical letter. He doesn't need resumes about a story, but this is free, untouched, unpolluted. Not apologized.
Was the one who managed to film a lot of the footage from the cult, which is what the movie is mainly based off. And more allegations around that, around Jamie, was that when they were putting the film into preview, Jamie sent a few of his followers to physically threaten the producers and the cast, some of which were ex-followers, basically so that the cult information or whatever didn't get out. So he was obviously quite scared about that, because that would expose him. Bearing in mind, Will Allen was suffering from him for 20 years. When he joined the cult, he was invited by his sister. Obviously they don't blame each other for anything, because it was complete manipulation by Jamie Gomez. So, you know, they both endured 20 years of this torture from Jamie Gomez. In 1990, I do believe they were relocated from Texas to Hawaii. In 2006, they were settled there, after looking for many locations, I'm just guessing. So the preview for the film Holy Hell, which was based on The Cult by Will Allen. I believe was previewed on January 25th, 2016 by Sundance Film Festival. There was one time, I believe, when Chris tried to confront Jamie whilst they were in Hawaii, and that was the footage of that.
My birthday. Staying over there. And what are you doing?
Just being alive and enjoying.
Me too. I mean, it hasn't been easy. You know what I mean? You have a lot of disciples, I see, yeah?
No. People come and go. This is pretty much like people pass through.
Well, are you being a good boy?
No. I don't know what that is.
Don't you think you should learn what that is?
Good and bad. Better to find out what is best.
Yeah. Have you been being your best boy?
I'm just being.
So yeah, you can see that he was quite shocked, and maybe, I don't know, maybe he was, there's so many things that you can be thinking, maybe like, what are you doing here? Or, you know, you've come back to me even, I can control you again. Or, where have you been and what have you been saying about me? You know, he looks very, even the questions like, have you been a good boy? And he's like, well, you know, he's not exactly been saying that, oh yeah, everything's great. He looks very sneaky. And yeah, the sad thing is that all the allegations that were thrown against him, he was never convicted for any of it, ever, not even sexual abuse. He was, I don't know, charges were put towards him, but he was never convicted or fined or anything like that. He was never punished for it. And sad to say, the cult does still exist as far as I know, and it's based in Hawaii still, which is where the footage was last taken. So for all we know, he's still a cult leader even now. Some of his followers have gone with him, some have left. But fair to say that a lot of them are like, what was I thinking? Why did I go through that? And I can't imagine the regret of a lot of the women who had to have abortions, and how many times I might have had to have abortions with all the sexual activity going on. So it was a really crazy cult. Apart from the harassment and stuff like that, it's not the worst cult that I've come across. But no less, it still is an awful cult where somebody has controlled a lot of people's lives for a long time. You know, I'm sure there was loads of moments where it was fun and people just having the time of their life, especially in those days, the 1980s and 90s. It's like the time to have fun. But ultimately, you have wasted a lot of your time, especially for people like Will Allen, who was, you know, in there for how many years? 20 years. So it's not the greatest cult, it's not the greatest place to be, but yeah, that's it. Anyway, so with that being said, I do hope you kind of enjoyed this information about him. I know that, again, it's not a very well-known cult, so yeah, trying it out, why not? It's a new thing I'm trying for my vlog channel. If you did like it, please do give it a thumbs up. If you'd like me to look into other cults or even serial killers, comment down below. I'm happy to look that up for you. And if I haven't mentioned already, subscribe to the channel, because I do like giving you good content. Other than that, please don't try to join any cults. yeah. Or you can join mine on my YouTube channel by subscribing. Until then, until that moment, yeah. Good night, God bless, I hope you have a great day.